for you. Make sure your hair looks okay.
I have to do this all the time.
Really bad today. Hey guys, I'm here with another unboxing video, and this is the first time I've actually had anyone in one of my unboxing videos. You know who this is? This is Connor.
You better know who I am.
Go subscribe. If you know who I am and you don't know who he is, then there is something wrong. Anyway, quick backstory. These boxes are the Funko Black Friday mystery boxes, or so I thought. Thumbnail. Or so I thought, because how many weeks has it been since Black Friday?
It's been a month. I'll just say that. It's been like a few days shy of a month.
It's been a hot minute since Black Friday. And we have this mystery box
from Christmas. It'll be a month.
From GameStop. I made sure to watch Nerdy Noob's video before getting any of these. I'm getting, I believe, one from my Grammy and one from my grandpa for Christmas, and then I'll have an unboxing video. Funko Mystery Boxes, X2. And I wasn't going to go crazy on them because you don't know what you're going to get, and some of the boxes come with, like, you get the same thing of one of the items, which I'm not going to, like, you know, but...
Right.
Yeah, but they were going to, I was like, they only have a few left at my local GameStop. I might as well pick up one. They were $19.99 a piece. And you're going to get a Funko Pop and some other items. And, of course, at the end of it, I'm going to do pricing and recap. But other than that, I mean, I think that's about it. When you don't cut the tape, because the plastic wrap has already been removed, they had to put plastic wrap on it because there's been, like, problems with employees in the past when they didn't put plastic on it, like, breaking into it and, like, taking... You have a chance of getting special gold and metallic pops in these boxes. So we're just going to see when you open it up. This is what you're gonna see. Can already see.
It's a Mega Man looking thing.
It's
right?
Mega Man. I'm not complaining.
Oh, is that Suicide Squad there? Yeah.
We got our mystery pop, which is an only at GameStop pop, which is nice.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is.
I've never played Mega Man.
I've never seen anyone get this pop. The guy at the store was like, do you want me to put some voodoo on this, or do you just want me to pick one? I was like, just pick your best guess. Okay, so these are the other ones you can get in the collection. We got,
I think I would like Blue Mega Man the best, just because I don't, I haven't played Mega Man, but that's the one, like, I know of him.
Quick Boomerang. I actually don't know this character. I know the other characters. I know Mega Man, Rush, Proto Man, and Dr. Wily, which are the other ones you can get.
Oh, I know Proto Man. Isn't he like an enemy? Is he?
I don't know. I think he's just one of the. I think
if there's
he's
a Mega Man
fan
watching, they're gonna kill me.
I've played the very classic Mega Man, like on the arcade machine.
I know how. So. I know Proto Man. That's in a Mirror song.
He kind of has a flaw, but you know that's all right. Only at GameStop pop. Typically, exclusive pop figures cost you around $12. So, you know, I haven't seen anyone get one of these in the boxes that I watched. So, I mean, maybe it's a more rare one. It's not even represented on the back there. So, but that's neat. Definitely one of the better options. And then you have your this guy or girl comes in. Every single Funko box. So if I have, I don't even remember if I ordered one or two more, but whichever ones I ordered, I'm gonna have however many of these. Maybe that'll be a giveaway I can do, so I don't have to spend extra money. I was thinking about doing. I'll talk about that later. We got Enchantress from Suicide Squad, which I haven't seen the new Suicide Squad movie. I heard it was.
Don't even bother.
I heard it was.
She's the main villain in the movie.
Iffy.
And she's not even that great of a villain.
I'm gonna put it back in the box, but let's just, you know, why not? I've never seen a rock candy figure before. It's kind of
cheap. Kind of cool.
It's kind of cheaply made. Let's get her on there somehow. Something like that. Maybe the other direction. There we go. The thing I don't understand is why they put the same... Why they put the same rock candy in every single box when there is so many rock candy figures. I don't know. We'll figure out how to get it back in the box. They have, like, looks, so many rock candies.
The actual Enchantress looks a lot more sinister than this.
Yeah, you know me, I don't take my figures out of the box, typically, except to, like,
I don't either.
Show them.
Well, okay, I have one pop figure, I don't take it out of the box, but, like, the thing is I want to, but I know you shouldn't.
So. I took my Vault Boy out of the box, but I still have the box, so as long as you keep the box. Yeah, this box is a little bit, dented, but I'm not, like, I'm not whiny about box condition, like, it happens. There you go. Collect all of the DC Comics rock candy figurines. Exactly. Why did you put the same exact one in every box? But I'm gonna fix it later. We have, but it's an only at GameStop product. And then we have our last things, which are blind bags, which we can each open one.
Oh.
Another rumor I have heard is that these have not the same figure in them, but you'll get the same two every time.
Really?
Yeah, you have pint-sized heroes. I've opened up the DC Comics. These are also a GameStop exclusive. Five Nights at Freddy's, which I've actually
never played before. They have quite the fan base. How do I open them?
There's a tear tab.
Where at?
The top, I think. Right there. Oh. You got a silver. I believe this is Foxy. A silver Foxy.
This would be whatever the heck this thing is. It's a little crying dude. Does it say?
Cool.
It doesn't say.
They don't have a checklist or anything. That's lame.
What even is this? What even is this? Well, okay, I know this is one of the
That's
the
Silver
villains.
Foxy, and then that's...
What the heck? Is this supposed to be the character you play as? Someone comment, because I really have no clue. Never played it before.
Yeah. If the blind bags end up having the same figures in them, I'll definitely, you know, figure that out. It kind of looks like Paymax.
That's interesting.
Anyway, pricing and add up. This box costs $19.99. I think with tax, it ends up being like $21, but I'm going to just $20. So this Funko Pop. Funko Pops tend to be between, how much did you pay for yours, GameStop exclusive?
Mine was probably $12.
So we're going to give this one $12 because we have two games that's like GameStop exclusive. $12. This one is also an exclusive. I'm not sure how much rock candies usually range from. You should Google rock candy figure and just see like the price range
on it,
because and then I'll add a couple dollars for it being exclusive. If I end up with three of those, there's gonna be something taking place, just letting you know, because I don't need three of the same thing.
Looks to be about the same as a pop, a Funko. 1160, 1118. Wonder Woman here is 995. Got an old school Harley Quinn, $12.95. So I would say like 11 as the nice round.
I'm gonna say 11. I'll say 11 or 12. I'll round it about the same because it is an exclusive GameStop figurine. I don't know if it's GameStop only or only in this box. And then these little guys, I've bought pint-sized heroes before. They were around, I want to say around $4. These are exclusive to GameStop. I feel like they were $4.50 or $5.50, but I'm going to give these $5 each, because that's about how much they were. I only got the other ones because they were on sale, because they're kind of expensive. They're like $5.
That's kind of a lot for something so small.
The only ones I would actually pay for directly at this point is the new Spider-Man ones, because I'm pretty into Spider-Man.
Out of all of this, I think the pop would be the only thing I'd be even interested in having, and not even... this particular pop, because my collection currently stands at one.
With this guy, we got this guy, I have a Vault Boy, I have a White Run Guard, and I have a Skeleton Gerard Way, and I have TMNT, so I'm at five.
I got Ghost from MW2, hopefully at least someone knows what that is, and if you do, then you know how awesome that is. See, basically, there's a retro gaming store in our local mall. And they sell pops, but it's a gaming store, so they really only sell video game pops. That's really all I saw on there. Mm-hmm. And the Assassin's Creed pops they had today were garbage. Oh, nice. The Assassin's Creed pops they had today were garbage, so I didn't pick any. If they would have had Ezio, I probably would have ended up making a purchase.
Caving.
And I didn't see Ghost in there today. I saw other Call of Duty characters, but not Ghost.
Did you get Ghost at GameStop or the Retro Game?
I got it at that store. Like, I went somewhere. I think I went to FYE. And I saw a Ghost pop, and I'm like, maybe I'll buy that, but I didn't. And then I saw it again, like, a few days later at the Retro Gaming store. And I took it as a sign that I needed to get it. So I got it. And then when I went back there today, they didn't have it, so. And he's one of my favorite video game characters of all time. Like, top five, so. Definitely my favorite from the Call of Duty franchise.
Anyway, so here was your unboxing video. My last unboxing video was, the Lootware unpackaging video. Unfortunately, this month, the only Lootware item I have coming is the t-shirt. I don't have the Loot Crate coming at all. I don't have 1UP Box. The only one I might be getting is Loot Gaming. I have no idea. We might just have to wait for next month for those unboxings. And with the vlogs, it doesn't really matter that much. I just decided I was going to give this a shot.
Bloopers.
It turned out well enough. Like, I feel like I got one that not every single person gets. So, that's good. I am still kind of mad that you get the same exact Rock Candy figure in every box. Cause
yeah. I don't think I would purchase that. Because I didn't care for Suicide Squad that much. So,
I was just going to give it a pop. Get it. Give it. I'm gonna give it a pop, and overall, the end price ended up being, I said, $12.12, so that's already $24.
Yeah, I mean, value-wise.
Value-wise, it's about $34 worth, but it also sometimes depends on personal preferences. You know, some people might pay $20 on eBay for that Enchantress pop or Rock Candy if they really like it. It just depends all on preference. Overall, I think they did a good job with the value. I'm not completely disappointed. I think I'm going to give it a 3 out of 5 because I can't give it like a lower rating because of what I got, because it's a mystery. Like, you're taking a chance. It's a lucky dip. So value wise and item quality wise, and the fact that they gave you 2 blind bags, a Rock Candy and a pop, like variety wise, I'm going to have to give it a 3 out of 5.
Yeah. I would go 3.5 out of 5.
3.5.
Just because, I think there are people that would have paid $20 for either figure by themselves.
That is very true.
And if, with, like, them together,
you
plus the
missing
blind
it.
Bags, that's a good deal, I would say. It's a good deal. Mm-hmm. If you're a fan of if Mega Man is a game you played as a kid, and you went and saw Suicide Squad and you really enjoyed it, then you should probably buy this, because it would make a lot of sense for you.
You will guaranteed get the Rock Candy figure.
The Enchantress, right?
Promised. The blind bags, I don't know if they're Five Nights at Freddy's every single time, but I feel like they are because it was a new release. So this had, I think they had this to showcase their new releases at the end of the year.
Well, it definitely makes sense because, you know, Suicide Squad was a movie this year. Five Nights at Freddy's, I don't know when it came out, like a couple years ago, mm-hmm. but it's like massively popular.
It's
can't
definitely
deny that.
Retained its popularity.
Oh yeah. Like, you go into GameStop and they have so much Five Nights at Freddy's stuff, I can't even believe it.
Well, anyway, lastly, if you want to get this box, they should still have them available at GameStop's website or at your local GameStop store or local Think Geek store. They recently put a Think Geek near us, so that's really cool.
They did?
Yeah.
Where?
I mean, I'm not going to say where, but...
Like, what town? Is it, like... Okay, is it in your town or my town?
Neither.
Is it closer to your town or my town?
I want to say mine, but I'm not sure. I want to say it's like 20 minutes from my house.
Really?
So, yeah, but they also have blue boxes. Last thing, actually. Scratch that. Last thing. They also have blue boxes, which have a chance of getting... I think they come with a Mega Pop and some other stuff. And those boxes are $29.99, but I just, when I'm taking my chances, I was going $19.99, not $29.99. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video and this unboxing, and I know the unboxings are becoming a little less common, but it's because of that.
Is this the last unboxing of the year on this channel?
No, because I am getting 1 or 2 more of these boxes. I don't remember.
Is it going to go up, like, in 2017, though?
Mm-hmm. No, no. It's gonna go up. It'll go up the day after Christmas, or 2 days after Christmas, whatever. Yeah, and then if I have Loot Gaming, that'll be the end of December as well, because that'll come in like, if I order that, it'll come in like a week, so it'll still be. We'll see. We'll see. All right. Yeah, that's about it. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I'll link the box in the description below if you want to order it for whatever reason. If you're not into that, then I'll talk to you guys later.
Are we doing this? We did it. Bye.